Hello and welcome to the Barclaycard Arena here in the city of Birmingham, which is located in the heart of England. And we're here for the Yonex All England Championships, the oldest tournament in world of badminton. This is the 105th edition, and that long tradition generates enormous prestige. This year, as you can see, Birmingham is the of the Super Series events. There was a change of calendar. The players had a two-month sabbatical, but they're all here and ready to do battle for the first tournament on the 12-event MetLife BWF World Super Series. Not only the first, but also the first of tier events, an even higher tier of tournament within the Super Series. Malaysia, Indonesia, Denmark and China, the other premier events. And of course, as you could see, the Super Series finals at the end of the year, and the destination once again this year, as indeed it was last year, is Dubai. Destination Dubai finals. Of course, as you could see, the Super Series finals at the end of the year, and the destination once again this year, as indeed it was last year, is Dubai. Destination Dubai finals, only for the top eight players and pairs in each of the five disciplines will qualify for those Super Series finals. Beijing in December at the end of last year was a huge success. The players are already talking to us about their desire to qualify once again for the Super Series finals and the Destination Dubai in 2015. Well, to our matches today, it's second round action, five matches for you, and we're starting with women's doubles and the reigning world and Olympic champions, Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei. They're up against the Indian pair of Jwala Gutta and Ashwini Ponnappa. Then we've got men's doubles, and what a sensation the Danes caused yesterday. Peterson and Colling, winners of the German event last week, beat the world number ones yesterday, Li Yongdae and Yu Yongsung. They're up against the Commonwealth Games gold medalists, Go Vi Shen and Tan Wei Qiong. Then we've got mixed doubles and the qualifiers, Sukamoljo and Polly of Indonesia, up against the English pairing, the married couple, Mr. and Mrs. Adcock. And it's been 10 years since England last won a title here. Then we've got women's singles and Pontip Borana Prasatsuk, the former world number eight. She's up against the European and world champion, Carolina Marin. Then we finish off with men's singles, Boonsak Ponsan, a courtside. There we can see it is the world and Olympic champions, Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei, up against the 2010 Commonwealth Games gold medalist, Jwala Gutta and Ashwini Ponnappa from India. So let's join our MC to get the players onto court, our MC Ben Witham.
Now we come to the women's doubles. Birmingham, please make some noise for the number one seeds from China, Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei, and their opponents from India, Jwala Gutta and Ashwini Ponnappa.
Obviously, with the number one seeds in action, this is from the top half of the draw. I can tell you that in the women's doubles, there was a big sensation at the bottom half of the draw yesterday, because the number two seeds, Matsutomo and Takahashi, were beaten in the very first round. But this, obviously, from the top half. First duty of umpire.
Court three, men's doubles.
The toss of
from Indonesia, the number four seed.
Gavin Smith from England is our umpire. Joe Small, also of England, will be the service judge.
From China,
so the Chinese in the blue kit, number one seeds and number one pair in the world. Well, it's been 3 years since this Chinese pair were all England champions. In fact, 2012, they beat the number one seeds, Wang Xiaolin and Yu Yang, in the final. So as far as last year is concerned, well, six finals from 11 individual tournaments played. They won four of them. Indonesia Super Series, the World Championships, of course, Australia Super Series and Hong Kong as well. Just for good measure, they reached the final of the China Super Series and the Super Series finals in Dubai. So Zhao Yunlei is, of course, also the double Olympic champion. Well, they had a right battle, I can tell you, in the first match, because the two-time former world junior champions Shin Sun Chan and Lu So He took them the full distance, as you can see, an hour and 2 minutes. It was a very convincing third game. I watched that match and I think the Korean youngsters in the end just ran out of steam, but having to work very hard indeed. So to their opponents, the Indian pair of Jwala Gutta is the left-hander. Ashwini Ponnappa is the younger of the two players. She's 25 years of age from Bangalore. Jwala Gutta, 31. They're 22 on the world ranking at the moment. They have been as high as 13. And as you can see from their win-loss record last year, well, that translates into one final, and that was when they lost in the final of the Commonwealth Games. They played two tournaments this year. They were semi-finalists at their home event, the India Grand Prix Gold event, and reached the second round in Germany last week. Now, in their first match here, they got revenge for their semi-final defeat in India, in Lucknow, a couple of months ago, when they beat that Malaysian pair, as you can see, in three games. Well, I'm Jill Clark, and delighted to say that joining me is Steen Petersen, former head coach of the Danish national team. And of course, Steen, a tall order, really, for the Indian pair.
Yes, I think so. They've lost all their previous encounters against these two Chinese players, and the Chinese are heavy favourites to win this match.
Well, there is confirmation of what you just told us. This, the ninth meeting between the two, and the last time they met was in last year's World Championships. In fact, it was the first round of the World Championships in Copenhagen. So the umpire, as I was saying, Gavin Smith from England, Joe Small, the service judge.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Jwala Gutta, Ashwini Ponnappa, India. On my left, Tian Qing, Zhao Yunlei, China. Jwala Gutta to serve to Tian Qing, Laval, play.
So the former Commonwealth Games gold medalists Jwala Gutta and Ashwini Ponnappa getting this second round match underway against the former All England champions but reigning world and Olympic champions Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei. What a good opening rally.
Service over. One, love.
And of course, Steen, the first thing to note as we saw as the match got underway is that Jwala Gutta is one of the few players in world badminton in the doubles that serves forehand.
Yeah, I think actually she's the only one here at the Super Series level. She's just stayed with her forehand serve, and of course you get a little bit more different opportunities serving the forehand compared to the backhand service. It's easier to put some variation into it.
Oh, indecision, yeah.
Two, love.
Oh, that's a good interception. Zhao
Yunlei.
has actually been in 6 All England finals. And of course, she's a world class, currently world number one in the mixed doubles as well. Now, service fault called.
1-3. Ciao.
Well, trying to get confirmation. Now, let's look at the service judge. Ah, that was for struck above the waist. Now, there's a clear indication always given by the service judge.
We must say we have to agree with the service judge.
Absolutely. We ought to perhaps also explain, Thurstein, that the definition of a waist in badminton is not what you and I would call a waist, is it?
No, it's the lowest rib. Actually, that's the point that you should hit the shuttle lower than that point.
It's gone wide.
6-1.
One India!
Oh, good serve. Absolutely left stranded, Jwala Gutta. Oh, almost twisted an ankle too. I've got to ask you, because of course the Indian pair 2011 bronze medalists at the World Championships in Wembley, and played very well in the London Olympic Games. After the London Olympic Games, Jwala Gutta decided to take a sabbatical from badminton, took time out, and I think that, you know, I can understand why a player wants to do that, but I've watched her very closely ever since, and I think she's just slightly off the pace, because when you leave it at her age, she's 31, and I don't mean that unkindly, but it's more difficult to get back into the fast rhythm.
Yeah, I totally agree with you, and of course you could say that players experiencing injuries, they have the same experience, that is hard to get back.
8.
Especially if you take a year off and not doing anything at all. If you're coming back from injury, you still do some physical practice, you still do some recovery. So it is hard to take these long breaks from badminton and then get back to the top level.
Yeah. Yeah, that was nice. I like that. I like the use of the mid-court area.
3-8.
I think actually her partner Ponnappa, as we see in the picture here, she's improved over the last couple of years, taking the role as a playmaker in this ladies' double, where you could actually argue that they're playing some kind of mixed doubles with Gutta Jwala at the net. But I don't know. I noticed in the beginning that she has strapping on her right knee, Gutta, so I don't know if she's somewhat limited in her movements.
10-3.
Yeah, there it is. Oh, that's gone just
11,
long.
11-3, interval.
And therefore an 8-point advantage. And the world number ones, the world Olympic champions, looking very much in control. And only 5 minutes of play to get to this big game interval. Liu Yong, their coach.
Well, 120 seconds, court 1, 20 seconds. Okay. 11-3. Play.
Oh, it's called good.
Service over.
Well, no challenge.
4-11.
The Chinese pair. Oh, and that's why. That was plumb on the line. Great call, line judge.
Service over. 12-4.
Yeah, I think your spot earlier, Steen, is absolutely correct. That last point, Jwala Gutta wasn't able to move
13-4.
And push forward to that drop shot.
Oh, I totally agree. I think this is quite serious, actually.
Another drop shot to her. Oh, that's good judgment. It goes long.
Service over. 5-13.
What would you advise then, Steen, if you had a player that was struggling with injury at the moment? There's the two Indian coaches, Pilelu and Gopachand and Madhu.
Yeah, it's... It's a question whether there's a risk of it getting worse, because then the good advice would probably be to stop the match. And there's a tournament next week in Switzerland. I don't know if Ponnappa and Gutta are entered into that tournament, but a long, long competition period is ahead of them. And if you want to qualify for the Olympics in Rio in 2016, you definitely can't afford long injury periods.
Yeah, well, they are entered into Switzerland next week, I can tell you that. So, our first Hawkeye challenge of the day. And the shuffle was out.
Challenge successful. Service over, 14-5.
It seems like she's a little bit affected as well herself. Gutta, not really that fighting spirit that we used to see in her.
Yeah, I guess from my perspective, I know she's such a wonderful front court player, and you alluded to this earlier by saying that the Indian pair almost play a mixed doubles with getting Jwala Gutta forward to the net. Ashwini Ponnappa has got such a powerful smash, and she's such a hard worker from the back. I'm almost tempted to, if I was coaching, but I don't coach, so I'd probably get it all wrong anyway, but I'd almost say, yeah, literally try and play a mixed doubles here.
Yeah, that's probably the only
service over
viable
16,
way if she's so limited in her movement as we suspect. It seems like she can move, but she can't put any power behind the moves.
Yeah. So they need to stay in that formation, but in lifting the shuttle, going out of it. Oh, what a good smash. Isn't that a wonderful example of the power and the accuracy of Ashwini Ponnappa?
7-16.
Look at that, from nowhere. Terrific shot. And Madhumita Bish, pleased with that.
Service over, 17-7.
Yeah, well, she is lethal in front of the court, isn't she? Zhao Yunlei.
Eight 18-7.
Of course, when you're down 0-8 in head-to-head matches, then an injury is not really what you're looking for if you're trying to get that first win. So this is, of course, going to be extremely difficult now for
19-7.
Please welcome Busana and Ongbun Rompan.
Shows us, Steve, 19. What the Indian pair are capable of.
Yeah, and probably we have a chance to see a little bit more of this because the Chinese probably sense right now that this is a match that is definitely winnable, so they might go down to like 90% of concentration, so hopefully we can get some more of these good rallies that we'd love to see.
Singing her praises already about her movement coming forward, her anticipation. Look, half a chance. Short, sharp movement of the racket head on that backhand kill. And already game points galore.
Service over, 9-20.
Third time of asking.
First game won by Tian Qing. Zhao Yunlei, 21.
2012 winners of this Yonex All England title. Looking very good in this second round match. 21-10. 14 and a half minutes. Now, the Chinese coach there, Liu Yong, of course, was doubles champion in 1997 in Glasgow, playing with UFA. There's an interesting comparison. How do you compare UFA, who was outstanding at the net? I thought she took women's doubles and mixed doubles to a new level in comparison to Zhao Yunlei and her qualities in women's doubles and mixed doubles.
And actually also
Gao Ling.
Three players that are very similar in their achievements, the way I see it. But Gefei, especially in the women's doubles with Gujun, were unbeatable at her best.
Yeah.
And I guess you could say the same goes for Zhao Yunlei, but the thing is that China has so many strong women's doubles. Wang Xiaoli, Yu Yang can challenge them, so they don't. Perhaps Zhao Yunlei hasn't won as much as if she'd been a couple of years earlier.
Very good point.
Court 120 seconds. Court
thinking
one,
as well
20
that,
seconds.
The comparison with Ma Jin, I often think of them as fairly equal, but actually I think we must say that Zhao Yunlei clearly has the upper hand over Ma Jin.
Yeah.
Second game.
Players just about ready for the second game.
Play.
They'd built the opening. Yeah, Madhumita. She's pleased with it. They may have made the error in the end, but tactically, they were right. Look, they're way out of position. Oh, Ashwini Ponnappa needed to do probably was get that over and in. It would have been an outright winner. I used to play against her, you know, Steen.
Yeah.
She was a wonderful player.
Madhumita Bisht.
Yeah.
Now the coach.
Yeah.
Together with Gorbachev. They've been enjoying quite a bit of success lately.
Very much so.
To love.
Oh, she left it. It was the right decision in the end. But right at the start of that move, there was a backhand from Tian Qing that was absolutely magnificent. Generated power, kept it flat over the net. Well, from that moment on, the Indian pair were struggling. You see, that's the sort of thing. When I look at Zhao Yunlei and our discussion about previous great women's doubles and mixed doubles players, Tian Qing doesn't have that same ability and awareness at the net as Zhao Yunlei. And that's where I was so interested to hear your comments about the front court players. And you talked about Ma Jin, incidentally, former All-England champion in the mixed doubles. She and her partner lost first round yesterday. Zhu Qing and Ma Jin lost.
Yeah, very, very surprising.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, look at that. What a drop shot. Oh, she's got great disguise, has Jwala Gutta. Power play, first of all.
Of course, both Chinese players also are wearing strapping on their right knee, but that's more common.
Yeah, they do that the whole time.
Yeah.
Yeah, we don't usually see Jwala Gutta with any strapping on, so obviously a new problem. She moved better to that, though. Yeah, they're trying to isolate Jwala a little. Oh, nice drop. Good rally again. Brilliant.
Excellent shot.
Oh, it's gone wide. What a pity. There's such an excellent rally. Had to end on an error.
5-1.
And what I liked about that, Steve, is the fact that the Indian pair were taking the rally, dictating the pace, and really pushing the Chinese pair.
And that's what she can do, Jwala Gutta here. She can play the clever shots. Whenever she has the shuttle, something good happens unless she's under heavy, heavy pressure. Of course, in this match here, they're a little bit overmatched. The Chinese are a far better pair than they are.
But
that's her strength, the ability to play the good shots, the shots that hurts the opponent every time she's in contact with the shuttle.
That's pretty just wide.
7-1.
Oh, look at that. Where did that backhand come from? Oh, that is extraordinary.
And sometimes it's very, very hard to defend shots like this because they're so unexpected. It's like a 50-50 shot. Either it's in and it's a point, or it's out.
Yeah, but that backhand was absolutely extraordinary. This, the winning shot, she puts a bit of a reverse slice on that. Well, we said she had racket skills. If she wasn't carrying that injury, well, a 5-point deficit at the moment. But I sense they're far more in the rallies now.
Yeah, they're more in the rallies, and I think we would have seen a closer match had she not sustained that injury to her right knee. So the thing is, how do they get even closer to the Chinese players? And I think one of the issues is get more ladies doubles players to a good level, so the sparring back in India is of higher quality.
Yeah. Easier said than done. That's good judgment.
4-7.
Yeah, very good judgment. Deficit
five.
Just 2 points now.
7.
He's looking a little more anxious now as well. Shuffle had gone past Jwala Gutta and she turned her back to the net and she plays this. Yeah, she does. That's just incredible. You must have to have such spatial awareness, Steen, to be able to do that.
Yeah, or a little injury, so that it would be foolish to do anything else than try to play the clever shots and keep control of the rally.
Yeah.
But she does have great awareness.
Yeah.
And she was brilliant mixed doubles player before she decided to concentrate fully on ladies doubles. Used to play with Diju.
Yep. Diju Valiabitil. In fact, they reached the final of the Super Series finals. Was that 2008 or 2009? The year that Joachim Fischer and Christina Pedersen got injured after that. After winning the Super Series finals, he was out for about 8 months after that with a knee surgery.
Yeah.
But played against Jwala Gutta in the final of that, I'm sure.
That's right. That was when they won their first tournament. It must have been in 9, I think.
2009, yeah. Yes, that's the problem. That's pushing off from
nine,
that ready
six.
Position. Yeah. That's where she's struggling. You've got to hand it to Tian Qing because that's a beautiful drop shot. That's great control.
And a little bit disguised as well. Looks like a smash, so
yeah.
They have to react really, really quickly with a lot of power. And right now, Gutta is not capable of doing that.
Thank you. Tian Qing at full stretch at the net.
Service over, 10-7.
Yeah, well taken. A spreading of the arms from Zhao Yunlei, which, good umpiring. Gavin Smith just calling Zhao Yunlei over to say, don't try and influence the line judge. And certainly making an arms gesture. Look at that. Yeah, that is clear. Attempt to influence. I think actually the line judge made the right call and it was out anyway. So let's just confirm that. But players do get into the habit of just
spreading. 20 seconds, call for 20 seconds.
27 minutes from the game. Now, Steen, obviously, we're seeing the Indian pair doing much better in this second game than they did in the first. This Barclaycard arena is notorious for a bit of a drift. Yeah. Just explain where that drift is going.
Yeah, the way I see it, I haven't confirmed it with any of the players, but the way I see it, there's a little bit of a drift from the side where Indian pair is playing towards the Chinese pair. I don't know if you agree, but that was what I spotted yesterday.
So the shuttle is flying faster, going towards that far side of the court as we look down.
Yes, but but the problem is that sometimes there's different speeds of the drift in different kind of heights. So if you make a high clear, it's probably not affected as much by the drift as if you make a flat lock. But then again,
12-8.
What I discussed with the players was that the drift was not significant this year. There's some curtains at the end of the arena here, and they're helping a lot controlling the drift.
Oh! 13-8.
That awareness, that alertness at the net.
And the way of measuring, there we see it again, the way of measuring how good you are at the net is actually
15-8.
Trying to measure how big a chance do you need to make an interception. And Zhao Yunlei, she doesn't need a really big chance, whereas Qingchen, she can also intercept at the net, but she needs a little bit of a bigger chance, a little bit of a higher shuttle above the net.
Oh. Yeah. Well, it's interesting because, in my opinion, both these pairs have a world-class front-court player, Jwala Gutta, the left-hander for the Indian combination, and Zhao Yunlei for the Chinese pair, and it's developing quite a lot into a battle between those two and for dominance at the front of the court.
In ladies' doubles, it's so important that you can have your roles, you can have the front court player and the back court player, but you need to be able to function in the reverse role because you will get targeted, get moved out of your favorite position. So pretty much your playing strength, overall playing strength, is dependable on how well you function in your secondary role.
Service over.
Yeah.
16-10.
Yeah, that's a very good point. Gone are the days where back in the dim and distant past when I was playing, that, you know, you could virtually stay in one area of the court. Any weakness in any department will be exploited nowadays.
That was well played by Ponnappa, and we've seen her try to improve her front court skills playing mixed doubles with Russian Vladimir Ivanov. Had to retire during the qualification rounds, but that's a good plan in order to get better at the front court play some mixed doubles.
Yes, I think we've seen over the last couple of years Japanese women's doubles players doing 11. That. Tormo is the one that springs to mind, and I think she has improved at the net, despite the fact that they lost yesterday, number two seeds out first round, which was a huge shock. But you're right, that development as a player for your favoured discipline by playing another discipline, and I don't think players do enough of that nowadays.
No, let's hope that it's getting its way back. Later on, we're going to see the Danes calling, doing well in men's doubles and mixed doubles.
Yeah.
So it actually can be done.
17.
Nice quick serve.
An odd match for the Chinese pair as well, because I guess they have a pretty solid feeling that they're going to win it, but so you might want to use it preparing for 18, the match in the quarterfinal. Well, but it's a little bit of an odd matchup here because the Indians are playing so lopsided, you could say, that Ponnappa is playing the men's mixed role. So it's not the same that they're going to face tomorrow. So actually, it's just about getting the win and go back and relax.
Yeah, and of course for Zhao Yunlei, she'll be on court later with her mixed doubles partner, Zhang Nan. Bit of frustration being showed from Tian Qing. That's a good forehand serve, isn't it? You watch a serve like that, one wonders why on earth more players don't try it. Oof, good judgment again.
Service over, 19-13.
We're just 2 points away from a place in the quarterfinal. Yeah. Struggling to push forward once again, Jwala Gutta.
13.
Just can't lunge forward. So 7 match point opportunities for the number one seeds.
Yeah,
first time of asking. 21-10, 21-13. And just a fraction under 36 minutes, and the former champions Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei are through to the quarterfinals.
Match won by Tian Qing.
So their confirmation
of the scoreline. 21-10,
21-13. A very impressive performance by the reigning world and Olympic champions Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei. So the Chinese pair, well, they'll play the winners of either the number 6 seeds, Oreka Kakiwa and Mayuki Maeda of Japan. They'll be playing against Isabel Hertrick and Birgit Mikkels of Germany. That match yet to happen, of course, but they're safely through to the quarterfinal. So Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei, the world and Olympic champions, safely through to the quarterfinal. And as I was mentioning before, they'll play either Kakiwa and Maeda or Hertwig and Mikkels from Germany. Well, men's doubles is coming up next, and the Danes, Mads Conrad Pedersen and Mads Pilakoli up against the Malaysians, Govi Shem and Tan.
Service cool, sir. Tan. Malaysia, you're on that side? Yep.
So the Danish pair, well, when they looked at the draw, well, they would have been hoping that they'd still be playing on the second day, but most people probably would have thought that was unlikely, because the Danish combination in the black kit, well, on the right is Mads Conrad Pedersen. Both these athletes, 27 years of age, both turned 27 in January. Mads Pilakoli, well, he is a giant of a man, 2 meters and 5 centimeters. Number 11 in the world ranking, they've gone up 2 places. That was published earlier today. Up 2 places to a career high, number 11. And that's after winning in Germany last week. So their first match was against the number 1 seeds, Li Yongdei and Yu Young Sung. And look.